The embedded web server is a web server running inside the printer. You can use it to obtain printer information, calculate the cost of the jobs, automatically send notifications by email from the printer, and troubleshoot problems. Service engineers can use it to retrieve internal information that helps to diagnose printer problems. This video shows you how to access the main functionalities of the embedded web server in the HP Latex 110 printer. You can access the embedded web server remotely through an ordinary web browser running on a computer connected to the same local area network. First, take note of the printer IP address by pressing the connectivity icon on the printer's front panel. Type the IP address into the computer browser's address bar and then press Enter on your keyboard. The language used will be the one specified in your web browser options. If you specify a language that is not supported, English will be used. In the embedded web server pages, you will always find the name of the printer, the host name and the IP address, the printer status, and a help button that will provide extra information about the page you are currently viewing. Use the main tab to obtain print information and calculate the cost of jobs. From the main tab, and by selecting the supplies option, the status of the printer's user replaceable parts is displayed graphically. The traffic light shows whether maintenance is required. For more detailed information, select Click to view details. The usage page displays substrate and ink consumption from the time the printer was first used. Information on total ink consumption is approximate. The accounting page shows relevant information about the latest jobs printed. Information on total ink consumption for each plot is approximate. By clicking Export to Excel at the top of the page, you can download the accounting page information in the form of a Microsoft Excel spreadsheet. The accounting page includes costs information. By default, the cost assigned to ink and substrates is zero. Using the Cost Assignments tab, you can introduce your ink and substrate costs. You can change the currency and some other parameters by selecting the Edit Units option. You may find more details and features on the accounting functionality at www.hp.com/go/designjet/accounting. Use the Setup tab to change the settings of the printer. In this video, we will show settings that cannot be changed from the front panel of the machine. Selecting the printer settings option, you can change the number of jobs shown in the accounting page. If the printer is web connected and the email server is correctly configured, you can configure the printer to automatically send the accounting information to the specified email addresses. You may find more details and features about the accounting functionality at www.hp.com/go/designjet/accounting. Some features, such as notifications, will not be enabled until the unit is connected to the internet. Use the internet connection page to configure it. This configuration is also accessible from the front panel of the printer. If you are not using a web proxy, then simply check the Enable Access to Internet box. If you do not know if you have a web proxy, then first try without a proxy. And if it does not work, try configuring the internet connection with the web proxy server information. If you are using a web proxy for the internet connection, you will need the proxy address and port information. If you do not know how to obtain this information, contact your IT personnel. To confirm that the printer is correctly connected to the internet, you must go to the Support tab and click on Connectivity Troubleshooting. Select the Internet Connectivity Test and click on the Run Test button. If everything is correctly configured, this is the result you will get from the test. When you are sure the internet connection is working properly, you can return to the Setup tab. In order to enable the automatic notifications, you must also configure the email server. You will need the SMTP server and port information. If you do not know how to obtain this information, contact your IT personnel. The printer email address does not need to be a real, functional email address, but it should be unique so that the recipients of the message can identify the printer that sent it. You can use the notification page to ask your printer to send notifications by email whenever certain specific incidents occur. Notifications can be sent to multiple email addresses. In order for alerts to function, outgoing mail must be configured on the email server page. To start sending from your printer, click on Alerts Destinations. Type the email addresses the alerts must be sent to. Select the type of alerts you want the printer to send. This video does not cover the firmware update or management of substrate presets because dedicated videos have been created for these features. The networking tab enables you to change the printer's network configuration. Usually, the printer automatically configures the LAN connection, and you will not need to change any of the settings to use the printer. If you need to change any LAN connection setting, you will find it in this section of the embedded web server. You may find all the details about the LAN settings in the printer's user manual. If you do not know how to change the LAN settings, contact your IT personnel. The support tab offers various kinds of help with your printer. Using the troubleshooting browse information and HP links pages, you can access the usage and troubleshooting documentation published by HP. The connectivity troubleshooting page allows you to check the status of the printer connections and to troubleshoot possible connectivity issues. The information on the service support page is really important when you call your reseller or HP to get its support. The printer information shows current and historical data on the usage of your printer. The most complete information is provided in the All Pages tab. Collecting the information might take a while. You can find additional helpful videos at hp.com/support videos and on our YouTube channel.